Are you breathing? Of course you would. Deep breathing brings deep thinking, and shallow breathing, shallow thinking. Are you breathing correctly? Is your breath long, rhythmic and deep, or shallow and erratic? Is your abdomen active while breathing or passive? Can you feel the breath in your pelvic diaphragm? Are you practicing your asanas just physically without being aware of your breath, where body and mind becomes rigid? Or try breathing more deeply, consciously, being aware of your breath, being mindfulness of what you are doing, whether on the mat or off the mat. One conscious breath in and out is a meditation. Breath gives you that space in life. So why not give that space while practicing the asana? Namaste friends. I am Ritesh, and today we would be covering video series of first point of yoga alignment, that is breathing. We have already covered the feet alignment. In this series of video, we would be discussing about breath awareness, types of breathing in brief, correct method of breathing, breathing in asana, whether you're static, that is you're holding the asanas, or when dynamic, that is movement based. So let's focus first on breath awareness. Breath awareness while practicing the asana helps you to be in a meditative state. Whether it's vinyasa or gentle yoga, it will reduce injury. Changes happen at cellular level, and it improves the functioning of the lymphatic system, that is the drainage system of our body, activates the parasympathetic nervous system, that is the rest and digest response of the body, and good amount of blood circulation at the pelvic floor muscles. When you are just being aware of your breath, even if you don't do deep breathing, eventually breath awareness will lead you to deep breathing. And now, let's focus on types of breathing. So, there are various types of breathing, such as abdominal breathing, also known as belly breathing. Second, chest or thoracic breathing. Third is yogic, friendly breathing or diaphragmatic breathing, or dirgha shwasam. Let us first understand anatomically in brief the respiratory system. The torso consists of two cavities, the thoracic and the abdominal. The thoracic contains the heart and lungs, and the abdomen contains the stomach, liver, pancreas, small and large intestines, kidneys and bladder, among others. Now, both share an important structure, the diaphragm. It forms the roof of the abdominal cavity and the floor of the thoracic cavity. So, when I breathe in through the nose, it goes into the windpipe, my lungs expand. Now, we have a diaphragm here. As I breathe in, this diaphragm creates a negative pressure on the upper portion, and that diaphragm starts pushing the abdominal content outside. Now, diaphragm, in any type of breathing you do, whether it is belly breathing, whether it is chest breathing, the diaphragm does move, but the intensity would differ. It's very important for you to understand what are the different types of breathing, how the mechanics of diaphragm works. Then only it is very easy to understand what type of a breath pattern or technique of breathing would be helpful when you're doing the asanas. Fine. So see you soon. Hope you enjoyed my video. Namaste. Now friends, in this video we covered what is breath awareness, what is the anatomy of your respiration, and the types of breathing. Now, in the next videos that are about to come, I would be discussing about in detail what is chest breathing, that is also known as your thoracic breathing, or the next is your abdominal breathing, or known as belly breathing. The third, that is your diaphragmatic breathing or yogic breathing or friendly breathing. And the fourth that I will be covering, the most important thing, is which breathing technique or which type of breathing would I use when I am doing the asanas.